Good morning. Thank you, Janet. Thank you, Stuart, for having me here. Almost everything they teach us about the ancient history is wrong. The origin of man, civilizations, and pyramids. For pyramids, they said they are built in Egypt and Mexico. It's wrong. That's just the beginning of the story. They are built on all six continents. For Egyptian pyramids, they said they are built as a tombs for the pharaohs. Again, wrong. The biggest, the oldest, the most superior pyramids were never tombs for pharaohs. For the pyramids on Mexican soil, they are saying they are built for the ceremonial purposes to sacrifice the enemies. Again, wrong. Not a single proof for that, except for the most recent Aztec pyramids. As you will see, we will need to rewrite the whole history, especially because of the pyramids. Egyptologists claim that this is the oldest pyramid on Egyptian soil, the famous Step Pyramid in Saqqara. According to them, it was built by the Pharaoh Djoser of the 3rd dynasty, 4,600 years ago. However, under the pyramid, in the tunnels and chambers, a lot of ceramic pieces have been found, and it dates to 5,800 years before present, which is 1,200 years before the reign of the Pharaoh Djoser, and 600 years before the Pharaonic Egypt. So who really built this colossal structure? Egyptologists claim that Pharaoh Snefer, the last one of the 3rd dynasty, built not one, but three colossal pyramids. This was the first one in Dahshur, the famous bent pyramid. This was the second one, a beautiful red pyramid, also in Dahshur. However, when you enter the pyramid in the passageways, no paintings. On the walls, no hieroglyphic writings. The chambers are completely empty. So where are the proofs that the Pharaoh Snefer was buried there? None. Egyptologists claim that he was not happy with the first two, so he built the third one, the Step Pyramid in Meidum. Again, no mummy in any of the three pyramids. Inside, everything is empty. No symbols, no tools. And then according to the Egyptologists, during the 4th dynasty, the pharaohs Cheops, Khephren, and Myseren, father, son, and grandson, built three of the most famous pyramids. However, outside, we don't see signs who really built them. When you get inside, beautiful passageways, megalithic stones, but no writings, no paintings, no hieroglyphic symbols, no tools, no mummies, no organic materials that belong to the pharaohs of the 4th dynasty. Not a single proof of who, when, how, and why built those structures. When we look at some of the dimensions, the length at the base, 232 meters, two lengths, 464, divided by height, 147, the result is 3.14, which is the number pi. According to Egyptologists, that number will not be invented until Pythagoras' time, 2,000 years after the 4th dynasty. But this number is here, in front of us. The builders of the pyramids, they knew about that number. Also, the golden ratio is built in the pyramid. Also, the distance between this pyramid and the sun is incorporated here. The distance between the pyramid and the moon is incorporated here. The number 299,000 kilometers per second the speed of light, is built here. You go to Egypt, Egyptologists and historians will proudly show you the tools from the Egyptian Museum in Cairo. The soft copper tools and wooden sticks. According to them, these were the only tools needed to build a structure which we cannot repeat today in the 21st century. So who really built them and what was the purpose? When you look at the art on the vases in pre-pharaonic times, you can clearly see, besides the boats and the animals, four distinctive pyramids. So the pyramids were there before the pharaohs. 7,500 years before present, a lot of them on pre-pharaonic art. We go south, 3,000 kilometers, to the northern Sudan, or the Nubian kingdom, 224 pyramids. And really, the world of the past was the world of the pyramids. 100,000 pyramids in Mesoamerica, in what we know today as the countries of Mexico, Guatemala, El Salvador, Honduras, and Belize. For the longest time, this one was thought to be the biggest one in the northern Mayan city of Tikal in Guatemala, 94 meters, four sides. However, 7 years ago, going more north in the Guatemalan jungle, the Mayan city of Tikal, which is completely covered by the vegetation, a bigger pyramid was discovered, over 100 meters, 330 feet. When completely cleaned, this pyramid is so huge that it will take the biggest pyramids in Tikal as maybe 60%. You enter Palenque, one of the most beautiful Mayan cities in the Mexican state of Chiapas. This is the first view. Look like a hill. Actually, this is a pyramid, carved by soil and the vegetation. Of course, this is much better known view of the pyramid of Lord Pakal, or Temple of Inscriptions. 12 years ago, in my books, I wrote that the network of underground tunnels will be discovered in Palenque. I was there 6 weeks ago, and finally, they did discover a tunnel which leads from this tunnel, from this pyramid, to the next two pyramids. But now they are saying that it's probably a network which connects this Mayan city with others, tens of miles away. The biggest pyramid in Palenque is this one here. Not cleaned and reconstructed yet. Much bigger than anything else known in the Mayan world. This is at the same time the oldest Mayan pyramids. In all history books, they are telling us that those rounded plates in front of the Mayan pyramids were used to sacrifice the enemy as the altars. Finally, a few years back, they did very detailed electronic microscopic analysis, and they discovered that there are no traces of blood. So it was not used for that purposes. The idea that the Mayans were Neolithic tribes, rather primitive, even though they had certain peaks in astronomy, math, and construction, is not valid anymore. This is the biggest pyramid in San Andres, El Salvador. Of course, not clean yet. And this is its original view. The pyramids on European soil, the island of Sicily in the Mediterranean, 43 step stone pyramids, built from the volcanic stone. The cornerstones nicely shaped on both sides. Pyramids on the western side of Africa, the Canary Islands, the biggest one is Tenerife. Dozens of them on this island. Again, volcanic stone, step design, four sides, plateau on the top, the cornerstones nicely shaped, the height of the steps the same, the width also. When you climb the pyramid from this western side during the summer solstice, June 21st, the summer rises exactly in the middle of the plateau. So it means it has the orientations towards the summer solstice. When I had my lecture at La Laguna University on Canary Islands in Tenerife, I spoke to their professors and I asked them if they visited the Güímar, the place with the pyramids. They said, yes, we did, but we don't know if they are pyramids. I said, of course they are. You can see four sides, geometry is there, orientation is there, construction material is there. They got very upset and they told me, well, according to our Spanish scientific view, these are not pyramids, but a pile of rocks made by local farmers when they were clearing the area to plant the vegetation. They got upset, they left, and they never came to my lecture. However, I had 350 students. When I talk about the pyramids, I got a standing ovation. People want to know truth. What's the problem with the people in Spain, in academia? 550 years ago, the Spanish conquerors were sailing to the West, Middle and South America. And the first one to feel what they were capable of doing were Guanches living on Canary Islands. Very peaceful community, but very developed. They were building stone cities, pyramids, temples, irrigation channels. But they did not have a military because they did not have an enemy. Over the next few decades, in the 16th century, Spanish totally wiped them out from the face of the planet. And today, in order to justify those acts, they were saying, oh, Guanches were primitive, barbaric, caveman level. So they falsify the history. You go on the other side of the African continent, the island of Mauritius, in the middle of the Indian Ocean, 5,000 miles away, seven stepstone pyramids, volcanic stone, four sides, plateau on the top, the same height, the same width, cornerstones nicely shaped. I've done the measurements over there. For example, one of the pyramids has a square base. The length of the sides 24 meters, 95 centimeters. 24, 95, 24, 95, 24, 95. This side looks at the east, at the sunrise during the summer solstice. So I wrote the report, sent it to the government of Mauritius, and I suggested that we start investigating those pyramids together. They sent me a letter back claiming, Dr. Osmanagic, we don't have pyramids. What you are describing is a simple pile of rocks made by local farmers while de-rocking the area. Pile of rocks. What is their problem? According to every encyclopedia, every internet source, until the 16th century, this island was not inhabited. And then white Europeans came. Spain, Portugal, Italy, Holland, UK. Of course, Europeans never built pyramids. So who did? In order to answer that question, they would need to change the history. The government doesn't like that. So, who to believe? Our own eyes or governments? This is one of the pyramids in El Salvador. El Chihuahuan, unless we could see the steps and few stones, we would never say that it was a structure a long time ago. In the Mexican state of Tabasco, the main city of Comalcalco, first view looks natural. In fact, it used to be a beautiful paved avenue with the step pyramids to the left. The ones to the right have been cleared and reconstructed partially. The most artistic man's town was the city of Copan in western Honduras. 1987 until 1989, the archaeologists from Honduras and the US were cleaning pyramids from the trees. And they discovered that inside the biggest one, there was excellent preserved temple, 700 years older than the pyramid itself. Obviously, in this particular case, pyramid has a purpose of being a cover, a protection for something even more valuable. Now, entrance to the temple, above, to the left and to the right, we can see something that reminds us of vehicles. Exactly on the top is a symbol for our solar system. Above that symbol, the white one, is the symbol for the core of the galaxy, the Hunabku. Look one more time. To the left, wheels, body of the vehicle, the cabin, and inside, we can see the profile of Mayas with their big noses. This temple is over 2,000 years old. Who had vehicles in the jungles of Honduras over 2,000 years ago? Or is the message for us that the Mayas were capable of moving between our solar system and the core of the galaxy thousands of years back? And how did they acquire all this knowledge about the astronomy? How did they know that our solar system moves within our galaxy, Milky Way, and that one cycle lasts almost 26,000 years, which will end December 21st this year, and a new cycle will start? In a tiny Belize, over 1,000 Mayan cities, towns, and villages, every one of them would have several pyramids, most of them still buried in the jungle. The biggest pyramid in Casablanca, El Salvador, partially reconstructed. And now we go to southern Peru. It's a beautiful country. 50 miles south from famous Nazca lines is a place called Cavachi. 7 years ago, talking to the Italian archaeologist, I found out that they discovered three step pyramids. 3 years ago, when I talked to them again, and I visited the place again, now they are talking about 34 pyramids. Who built the city of pyramids in Cavachi? Everything they tell us about it is wrong. They call this city the Sun City. We don't know its real name. They said that it was built by the Nazca culture. Again, wrong. Never in history, the culture under that name existed. There is a modern Nazca town, though. They're saying that the city was built 1,800 years ago. I asked them if they found any organic material in the pyramid. They said yes. In one of them, which they called the Pyramid of the Moon, they discovered the female bones, which was 4,500 years old. I asked them, how is it possible to discover a piece of organic material inside the structure? And the bone is 4,500, and the structure is only 1,800 years old? Their problem is, the official history is only 3,000 years old. So they falsify. We go to the north of this beautiful country, the area of Tucume. 250 pyramids. This is the biggest one, the Pyramid of the Sun. The pyramids in Peru are built from the adobe bricks. If you clean the walls a little bit from the desert sand, you're going to find beautiful walls. In the case of this particular one, we can see the vertical erosion. Obviously, the pyramids have been exposed to the storms and the rains for a very prolonged time. Now, the problem for the archaeologists is that for 7,000 years, in this area, the climate has been the same. It's dry, it's desert, it's sunny. No rains, no storms. So when did we have those storms? 8,000, 12,000, 50,000 years ago. This is the biggest pyramid in Peru, Huaca del Sol, the pyramid of the sun. Again, adobe bricks were used to build the structure. What we have left today from the pyramid, we can see that it took 150 million bricks to build the structure. Across is another one, Huaca de la Luna, the pyramid of the moon. Another 150 million of adobe bricks. There is a calculation which says that it would take 300 years, 15,000 people, to build this complex. Two problems. The first one, around not a few houses were discovered for the workers. We would need a city of 50,000 people to build this complex. And second, even if in the future those cities are found, the question is why would you start building a complex which will last 300 years? And the grandchildren of your grandchildren will not be there to see it finished. The most northern pyramids in Mexico is a place called Tula. According to all history books, Tula was the capital of Toltec civilization from the 8th to the 12th century. If you're talking to Mexican Indians, they will tell you Toltecs, they are not a culture. Toltecs are the most sophisticated and the most spiritual people that belong to Mayas and other cultures. But let's say that they were a separate culture. Today, only three pyramids were reconstructed. On top of one of them, we can see those eight stone cones. They call them Atlanteans. Toltecs, for themselves, they say they came from east, from the Red Country. East, from Mexico, is the Atlantic Ocean. And every column shows the face. Every face shows different race, a different color, black and white and yellow and red. Who had the knowledge about the people from all continents, hundreds and hundreds of years ago, before white Europeans came to the American continent? They tell us in the history books that there was no communication between continents until 16th century. They teach us wrong. Monte Albán is the second largest ceremonial city on the Mexican soil. This is one of the pyramids which has not been cleaned and reconstructed yet, waiting for better times and more money. The Chinese pyramids have been a mystery for the longest time. In 1967, the Chinese archaeologist who was investigating them went to the conference in Japan, and then he announced that 250 pyramids are in central Chinese province of Shanxi, and that he found some clay tablets with some type of hieroglyphic writings. According to his partial decipherment, the pyramids were built over 12,000 years ago. He came back to China. They put him in the mental hospital. And nobody has heard about him no more. The year is 1967, the first year of the famous Chinese Cultural Revolution. If you were thinking differently, then obviously the government would find a way to take care of you. After that, the Chinese government decided to plant the trees on the pyramids and to show them to the world as a simple, natural hills. In 1970s, no activities until mid of 1980s. And then the Chinese government gave the permission to the Chinese archaeologists to start investigating smaller pyramids. Out of 250, 230 are smaller ones and 20 big ones. So what they found out in the smaller one was a lot of archaeological material that do belong to the very concrete Chinese emperors, from the Emperor Qin 2,200 years ago until 1,000 before present. However, according to the leading Chinese archaeologists from the Archaeological Institute in Xi'an, they do not have permission to clean and investigate the biggest one, which are still covered by soil and vegetation. Why? Because it will take them 12,000 plus years before present. It does not fit the Chinese history, which is only 5,000 years old. What we know from the preliminary investigation is that the biggest one are built from the superior materials, granite and sandstone blocks, and the small one from mud bricks. The same thing in Egypt. The biggest one, Giza pyramids for example, limestone and granite. The pyramids of the 12th or 18th dynasty, mud bricks. And they're long gone. Obviously, two different civilizations, the one that they were before, much more advanced than the one that follows. All the Chinese pyramids, four sides, plateau on the top, perfect orientation, east, west, north, and south. South America, Bolivia, 13,000 feet above the sea level. Next to Lake Titicaca, the pyramid complex of Acapena, the step pyramids. Today, we don't see much, covered by soil, vegetation. However, we can see a lot of granite blocks around. You can see how those two blocks perfectly fit each other. Now, in order to shape the granite, which is the hardest material in the nature, today we would use diamond tools. According to the archaeologists, until 2,000 years ago, the only tools they had were copper tools. On a Mohs scale, from 1 to 10, granite is 6. On the same scale, copper is number 3, much inferior. You cannot shape superior materials with the inferior tools. Some of the blocks had a laser straight surface, which today we can use as the instruments. And some of them obviously had machine parts. The German-Bolivian mathematician and archaeologist Poznanski spent 50 years of his life investigating those pyramids. And he concluded that their age is 17,000 years. Who had diamond tools, lasers and machines 17,000 years ago? This is the look of the most known and most magnificent pyramids on Mexican soil, the Pyramid of the Sun, 150 years ago. Looks like hundreds of hills everywhere in the world. It took three archaeological campaigns for the American and Mexican archaeologists to completely clean and reconstructed. This is how it looks like today. One of the most beautiful examples of the pyramid architecture on the planet. When we look from the bottom of the pyramid, the tourists who are climbing the top, they are becoming so tiny. Looks like the builders wanted to reach the sky with this structure. And sure enough, its height 74 meters, 225 feet. Interesting thing is that the Great Pyramid of Egypt is exactly two times higher. The base of this pyramid in Mexico is square. The base of Great Pyramid of Egypt is square. The length, as we heard, of the Egyptian pyramids, 232 meters. The length of the sides here, 232 meters. Egyptian one has the number pi, this one has the root of number pi. There are three pyramids in Giza plateau, Cheops, Khafre, Meseren, three pyramids here, in the plateau of Teotihuacan, Sun, Moon, Quetzalcoatl. And their layout is exactly the same. They are telling us there were no communication 4,600 years ago between Africa and Mesoamerica. And here we can see the signature of the same architect. A Again, in my books, 10, 15 years ago, I was writing about the tunnels under the pyramids in Teotihuacan. Finally, 2 years ago, as a world sensation, was a news that the tunnels were discovered under the third smaller pyramid in Teotihuacan, Quetzalcoatl. They discovered about 40 meters, 50 feet of the tunnels. It's the work in progress. For the longest time, Egyptian pharaoh, Dr. Zahi Hawass, claimed that there were no tunnels under the Giza pyramids. So thanks to the independent explorer like Andrew Collins from UK and some others, now we know that there are tunnels under the Egyptian pyramids. Of course, we can see that Egyptian scientists are digging under the Sphinx in front of the pond and in the back. But they don't release those information. A huge network under the Giza pyramids that connects all the pyramids with the Sphinx and the River Nile. And the Chinese pyramids, all of them have those underground tunnels that lead to the chambers. So this is a common thing for the original and the oldest pyramids in the world. Underground network of tunnels and chambers. The pyramids in Mongolia, close to the border with China, similar to those like in Saqqara. Pyramids on US soil, well, nobody mentioned them in our history books. We have not one, but over 200 pyramids close to here, in the state of Illinois, on the southwestern side, Cahokia State Park. The biggest one, which they call the Monk's Mound, has a surface which is 12% larger than of the Great Pyramid of Egypt. Our scientists call them mounds. Mounds is basically when you use dirt to make something. However, here we have four different construction materials: sandstone blocks, pebbles, rocks, sand. And when they would finish the structure, they would cut the grass and the soil in squares, turn them upside down, and cover the pyramids in order to build this structure. Equivalent of 226,000 trucks of construction material was needed. 226,000 20-ton trucks. Millions of tons of material. How many tens of millions of tons of material to build the whole complex with 200 pyramids? A magnificent one. Instead of proudly presenting to our kids in schools, we hide them. Everything they tell us about this complex is wrong. They call it the Sun City. We don't know its real name. They're talking about the Cahokia State Park. Cahokia was the minor Indian tribe that came in the 17th century. In this area and had nothing to do with the pyramids. They're saying the complex was built by the Mississippians, Indian tribes. Never in history, Indian tribe by that name existed. Now, does the tribe have the social organization to build a complex which required tens of millions of tons of materials? Of course not. It's a feature of very advanced civilization. All the pyramids have four sides, and those sides are oriented to the cardinal points, east, west, north, south. Now, north is very important. We're talking about the cosmic north, the true north, the location of the northern star. The builders who know the orientation at the true north are not tribes. They are advanced culture. All the pyramids, but one, the biggest one, that one had an orientation towards the magnetic north. There is a difference between magnetic and cosmic north. Magnetic, as we know, moves every year between Canada and Siberia and back. Last year, for example, it moved for about 26 miles. The builders who know the difference between magnetic and the cosmic north are not tribes. They are very advanced civilization. on Italian soil, much, much before the ancient Rome, five pyramid complexes. The biggest one is Monte Vecchio, three major pyramids, 1, 2, and 3. Still, as we can see, covered by soil and vegetation. However, the layout of the pyramids in Monte Vecchio, 1, 2, 3, exactly the same like the Giza pyramids, 1, 2, 3, or pyramids in Teotihuacan, 1, 2, and 3. The look of the Pyramid of the Moon in Teotihuacan, 150 years ago, and today. Every day, 20 to 50,000 people come to what Aztec called the Avenue of Death, the main street in this beautiful city. Every year they leave $5 billion to the Mexican economy. Every year 8.5 million people come to Egypt to visit their pyramids, and they leave $15.5 billion to the Egyptian economy. Archaeological tourism has become the engine for the economies. The Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun. We have learned so far that the pyramids have nothing to do with the pharaohs and the tombs. The pyramids of structure, geometry, architecture. 7 years ago, I first came to the central Bosnian town of Visoko, which is about 20 miles northwest from the capital city of Sarajevo. The reason for me to go there was the invitation from the local museum to see their exhibition. It had nothing to do with the pyramids. For the longest time, they considered this a natural hill. But after 25 years of pyramid investigation all over the world, after my PhD about the Mayan pyramids and temples, when I saw the perfect geometry, four sides, triangular faces, obvious corners, the same slope, and when I took a compass which showed me north, south, east, west, I immediately knew that this was not a natural formation, but artificial construction, a structure under the layers of soil and vegetation. So let's see how it looks like from the air. The town of Visoko, 20,000 people, two rivers here, the eastern slope of the pyramid, north. The last 7 years we got a very interesting phenomenon in Southern Europe. For the first time, a non-profit, non-government organization was formed to do the archaeological digging under the name the Archaeological Park Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun Foundation. In the last 7 years we have spent over 300,000 hours on archaeological digging, sample testing, lab analysis, and radiocarbon dating. And we've concluded and in the central valley of Visoko, we have at least five pyramids, which we named the pyramids of the sun, moon, dragon, earth, love, with a huge network of underground tunnels. And we named the whole valley the Bosnian Valley of the Pyramids. When we compare the sizes, this is a colossal Mexican Pyramid of the Sun.
Wow.
This is the Great Pyramid of Egypt, 74-147. And from this point up is the Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun, 220 meters, three times larger than the Mexican Pyramid of the Sun. Traveling all around the world, investigating the pyramids, I concluded that there are seven criteria which structure has to fulfill in order to be called a pyramid. And those seven elements are, first one, geometry. Of course you have to have geometry of the pyramids. In most cases, four sides. Of course, from a geometrical standpoint, they can be three or five. We talk about the Chinese pyramids, the ones in Mauritius, Mayan pyramids. The second element, the orientation. For some reason, all the Chinese pyramids oriented to the north. Most of the oldest Egyptian pyramids, north. Most of the Peruvian, all Cahokia pyramids, Bosnian also. The third element, construction material. The builders were using a local construction material. In Peru, as you could see, it was adobe bricks. They would take clay, desert sand, water, mix it, put it in the molds, under the sun, 25 days later, they had construction material. In Guatemala, they shaped volcanic stones, 32 volcanoes in Guatemala. In Mexico, they were using sandstone. In Egypt, they were using limestone and granite. In Bosnia, as we will see, they use a river conglomerate to make a concrete. The next element, the inner passageways. Egyptian, Chinese, Mexican pyramids, they do have those inner tunnels. The fifth element, the underground tunnels as a part of the complex. The sixth element, water, always extremely important for the pyramid builders. Location, the water above the ground, and especially underground water streams. And the seventh element, the sacred geometry. As we will see, all seven elements are fulfilled in the case of Bosnian pyramids. One of the young men from the city of Sarajevo did his master thesis about the Bosnian pyramids. When he exposed the pyramid valley to different lights from different angles, he was able to come up with this illustration, which tells us that the original size of the Bosnian pyramid of the sun is not only from here, 220 meters, but it extends all the way to the bottom of the valley. And now we are talking over 360 meters, 1100 feet. When I announced that the Bosnian pyramid is larger than Egyptian ones, I shocked the archaeological community. But obviously the real size will another shock. So if you go back to the time, this is four-dimensional visualization of the pyramid valley in Bosnia. Three main pyramids, the sun, the moon, and dragon, when we connect their tops, form a perfect equilateral triangle. Between sun and the moon, 2,170 meters, approximately 1.3 miles. Moon to dragon, 2,070, dragon to sun, 2,070. We have inner angles at 60 degrees. Top of the love, Earth and River Fornica, another equilateral triangle. Triangle within the triangle, sacred geometry. Now, when we extend those lines to the place where two rivers meet, we're getting a new point. And we're getting a base for the flower of life. The middle is, of course, the middle point in all triangles. And if you place some more, again, using the middle, the triangles, we are getting a sacred cube also. When we looked from the top of the sun pyramid, just before the sunset, the most important day for the ancients, the summer solstice, the shadow of the sun pyramid, comparing to locations of the western slope of the moon pyramid, we could conclude that this shadow formed another pyramid just next to this one, like we are looking at the mirror, with the same height. 2 months later, we still follow the shadow of the sun pyramid, the western slope of the moon, 6:30 p.m., 7:30 p.m., the sunset, the shadow completely covers the moon pyramid, with the top of the shadow touching the top of the moon pyramid. In a symbolical way, the builders are telling us the rule of the sun and the day is over, and the rule of the night and the moon starts. That's why we name them the pyramids of the sun and the moon. I've seen hundreds of pyramids with such name all over the world, but never such an obvious astronomical relation like here in Bosnia. We apply a very sophisticated analysis, which is called satellite thermal analysis, to find out whether we have some artificial structures in the Visoko Valley. We measure the temperatures during the daytime and during the nighttime, and then we were checking the energy heat, heat loss. If we have a case of natural hills, the heat loss is very slow because they are very compact. But if we have artificial structures due to existence of inner passageways, chambers, the energy is lost very quickly. This analysis showed us that the biggest and the quickest heat loss is in the case of the Sun Pyramid, Moon, Dragon, and Love. Our friend Dr. Harry Oldfield from the UK developed so-called PIP camera, which is based on Killian photography, which was invented 50 years ago. Now, Harry Oldfield had his camera for about 10 years. What he can do, he can film what he called bioenergy fields, which are not visible to the naked human eye. And they can show us very interesting energy phenomena. For example, he filmed a natural hill in Bosnia, a pointy hill. And we could notice that those bioenergy fields above the hill are horizontal. A few words about the archaeology. Since 2006, we've been doing the archaeological digging. This is the Sun Pyramid, north, east. These are the places where we actually did the digging. This is the corner between north and east, 45 degrees. All other places are showing the construction material under the layers of soil, approximately 3 foot. Northeast corner, the year is 2006, remove the layers of soil and we are finding a beautiful corner here. Northwest corner is shown with a green line. The red is just a perfect straight line. And the length from 560 meters to 760-200 meters, 660 meters. As we can see, the green completely matched the red one, meaning that the corner, northwest corner, is still very well preserved. Archaeological trench number 4C. We moved approximately 3 feet of soil and we are finding rectangular blocks. 13 feet by 5 feet, foot and a half, 16,000 pounds. Flat top, break at 90, flat side, break at 90, flat bottom, 6 flat sides, 6 breaks at 90 degrees. Obviously, this is not the work of Mother Nature, but of intelligent hands. We took samples from these blocks and sent them to 6 different institutes for materials. In Bosnia, in France, in Italy. Let's see what they said. From the Institute for Construction Materials, from Tuzla, from Bosnia, they concluded that this was an artificial construction material pulled at site. University of Sarajevo, they analyzed the sample, and they said that it was a man-made concrete. Now, there are two elements that determine the quality of concrete. The first property is the hardness. The harder the concrete, the better the quality. Our modern concretes in 21st century have hardness from 10 megapascals to 60 megapascals. The sample that was analyzed at the University of Sarajevo has the hardness of 73.6 megapascals, much better quality than what we make today. The second important property is the water absorption. If the water can get inside the concrete block during the winter, it freezes and then the concrete breaks. So the idea is to keep the water absorption as low as possible. Our norms today allow us to go up to 3% in water absorption. What we have here is around 1%, much superior than what we have today. According to all the books, the concrete was invented in ancient Rome, 2,000 years ago. So it was very interesting what the descendants of ancient Romans would tell us. We sent samples to Politecnico di Torino, in Turin, Italy. And basically they told us what we already knew, that the binding material for the concrete was produced by clay heating process. So the binder was clay, and it was a concrete. The leading expert in ancient concrete today on the planet is Dr. Joseph Davidovits of France. He established the Institute for Geopolymers, and he wrote 25 books about the ancient concretes and the building of Egyptian pyramids. He is a special advisor for the EU. When he got the samples, he told me it's obviously artificially made concrete. He put it under the electronic microscope and he found the binding agent, which he calls geopolymer cement. According to Professor Mohamed Pašić of the University of Zenica in Bosnia, who analyzed 50 samples, some samples reach unbelievable level of 133 megapascals. Never in human history such a good quality concrete was made like the one that covers the largest pyramid on the planet. So, the year is 2006, we started digging, removing the layers of soil, exposing those concrete blocks to the world. Of course, the photo shows our typical Bosnian productivity. One is working, one hand is working. And on the top of that, one is having a speech here. So, after the years of war in the 1990s, with a destroyed economy, one would say, hey, we have discovery of the biggest pyramids here in Little Boston. This is a chance for the prosperity, for the tourism, for the economy. Well, the cultural establishment of this country didn't think so. The first attacks came from the Bosnian archaeologists and historians from the University of Sarajevo. They were saying there were no pyramids in Bosnia because there were no pharaohs in Bosnia. No high civilizations. How is it possible to have pyramids? There are no traces of hundreds of thousands of slaves that would be required to build those pyramids. The National Museum from Sarajevo, they are attacking also. They are saying it's impossible, we know this terrain well, this guy came here to make money. And they wrote the first petition against the project. They sent it to the Bosnian government, asking the government to stop the project. Well, the Bosnian Prime Minister came in April of 2006. He saw those rectangular blocks. He said, this is a man-made concrete. He saw thousands of tourists coming to the site. He said, this is good for the economy. Mr. Osmanagic, you keep working what you're working, and don't worry about the jealous scientists. Well, those jealous scientists, they got very upset. They wrote a letter to the president of the European Archaeological Association, Dr. Anthony Harding, asking him to help them and to stop the project. So Dr. Harding started writing against the project, against our foundation and myself. but to no avail. He just kept working. Then he started a new petition, which was signed by 80 American, British and French historians, anthropologists, geologists, archaeologists. They were saying that I was running the biggest hoax. I had to be stopped. Well, the Bosnian government rejected that petition. Now he got upset. So they sent a letter to all national European archaeological associations in Germany, in France, in Italy, in Croatia, asking them to boycott the project, telling the archaeologists not to go to Bosnia. And if they do, when they come back to their respective countries, they won't be able to find a job as archaeologists anymore. Every conference they had from 2006, they had our project as one of the main topics. Well, in the year 2006, I did not have archaeologists from Europe. According to the law in Bosnia, if you are to do the archaeological digging, of course you have to have archaeologists, you have to have tools and equipment and the finance and the project documentation. So what we did, we asked the Egyptian government for help. I asked them to send us three archaeologists and Egyptologists. The first one to come was Dr. Ali Barakat, the guy with 40 years of experience in geology and archaeology. He wrote books about building of Egyptian pyramids. He spent 42 days in Visoko, in Bosnia. He wrote the report, and he had it at the press conference on June 23rd, 2006. He ended his report with the words, "The Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun is a man-made pyramid." A big boost for us. The same day, however, from the National Museum, they're sending a letter to his boss, Dr. Havas, saying, "Your man confirmed that the pyramids were built in Bosnia. That's impossible. You have to stop him." So, 2 days later, Dr. Havas is having a meeting on June 25th in Cairo between the Ministry of Tourism, Ministry of Culture, and his Supreme Council of Antiquities with one topic on agenda: the effects of the discovery of Bosnian pyramids to the tourism in Egypt. Now imagine 20% of that $15.5 billion. 20% of tourists, instead of going to Egypt, coming to Bosnia. The most tourists are from Europe, UK, from France, from Poland, from Russia. And Bosnia happens to be in Europe. 20% of $15.5 billion is over $3 billion. Discovery of the Bosnian pyramids is not a local issue. It's a global scientific, economic, and political issue. After the meeting, Dr. Havas came in front of hundreds of reporters and TV crews and said, "There are no pyramids in Bosnia. Those so-called concrete blocks are just natural blocks." Dr. Barakat is no expert in pyramids. And Osman Agic, he's hallucinating. Dr. Barakat went back to Cairo, to Ministry of Geology, where he used to be a worker. And he was fired. Because he dared to speak his scientific mind without asking for the permission from his superiors. What about us? Well, we kept hallucinating and opened the project for the volunteers from all over the world. Never in a science one project attracted so many volunteers from all continents, and they were helping us, coming at their own expense, to expose more and more areas with the concrete blocks. It lasted only 4 weeks. The end of July of that year, the Commission for the National Monument Preservation made a decision that the whole pyramid be claimed the nationally protected monument. Not because of the pyramid, but because of a tiny fortress which used to be on the very top during the medieval time, which was long forgotten. So they used that as the excuse. And then after that, we were not able to do any work on the pyramid of the sun. So what we did, even if the law says this is a national monument, you can submit a new project, which we did, together with the archaeological faculty of the Cairo University, the biggest one on the planet. Any country would be happy to have Egyptologists and archaeologists from Cairo University, any normal country. Well, the Federal Commission for the National Monuments rejected our projects 3 times with no explanation. And the Minister for Culture, in 2 terms, for 8 years, was saying publicly, as long as I am minister, they will not get the permission to dig over there. So what we have, those years, 2006-7-8, we had a little organization consisted of ministers, writers, journalists, some politicians from cultural establishment, like an organized group doing everything to start the project. So they would distribute different tasks. They would say, you make sure they don't get the permit, you make sure they don't get the funding, you make sure that they go on media, you make sure that they don't go to UNESCO. And it was all against one little non-profit foundation. The journalists were writing that this guy, Osman Nagic, he got rich by connecting with the mafia in Yeltsin's Russia in the 1990s. Interesting thing is that of all countries that I visited, I never went to Russia until a few years back, but they were doing everything to discredit you. So once they start talking against you, people forget what was the source of the news. And that's how it functions. Wikipedia and most of other media outlets. Again, what we did, we sued the government. After 5 years being in a drawer, in November of last year, we got the judgment from the court in Sarajevo, in our favor. And that Ministry for Culture and Commission for the National Monument Preservation, he said that what they did, they made illegal decision not allowing us to work on the Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun. For the first time in this little country, my non-profit won against the government. So we invited the people again to come, to work with us. And for the first time, we had archaeologists from 7 European countries, from Italy, from France, from Spain, from Hungary, from UK, from Croatia, and from Bosnia. They were not afraid of the sanctions of their archaeological associations. Those archaeologists, young people mostly, were showing me the letters from their university professors in which they threatened them not to go to Bosnia. But once they did, they got new letters saying, you will not be able to find a job in Milan or in Italy, in France, and so on. And they told me, this project is globally important, much more than our individual destinies. So we were investigating other pyramids also. The Pyramid of the Moon, finding a beautiful terraces. But not only the mainstream scientists were attacking us, those who claimed to be alternative, open-minded. Robert Schock invited himself to our site at the very beginning of the project. He spent 1 week, and since then he's been saying there is nothing there, it's all natural, natural formation. This guy is there to make money. He is there to get elected in the politics. He is running the biggest hoax Well, this thing about money, I don't promote it, but I spend over $250,000 so far. So where is that money? I got my business in Houston. And about getting election in politics, sure, we have election in Bosnia every 2 years. But I don't care about politics. You can help your country in so many other ways. Now, the Sun Pyramid is completely covered in this Henidiori concrete. This is our archaeological trench number 4C. We can see the rows of blocks, the first row, the second row, the third row, the fourth row, four rows of blocks. This is our archaeological trench number 4A. These blocks, they are reaching 32 tons or 70,000 pounds. Our archaeological trench number 5, number 10, number 12, concrete, everywhere, exceptionally hard. There has to be a reason for that, and I will talk about it. The Pyramid of the Moon, 46 archaeological trenches, from the bottom to the top, west, south, east. Everywhere we're digging, we are finding terraces, pavements, rectangular structures, vertical walls, more pavements, steps, shaped blocks and plates, more walls. Under the layers of soil is a huge pyramidal structure with the sides perfectly oriented to the cardinal points. The top of the sun, the top of the Moon Pyramid, we made a hole, we found the rows of blocks. The first row, layers of clay, the second row, layers of clay, the third row. The ancients were smart. They were using natural materials, but they knew the properties of them. For example, clay is excellent binder. Clay is waterproof. Clay is thermal insulation. And then clay gives the flexibility to the structures. In a case of earthquakes, the structure does not collapse. It breathes. Here we are at the top of the Moon Pyramid. There's a soil. First terrace, second terrace, the third terrace. The bottom of the western slope, we have larger plates here, clay as a construction material, medium size, clay, small size. When we analyzed, we can find the Fibonacci formula applied here. Another interesting structure is what we called tumulus in Vratnica. If you have conically shaped artificial hill, in archaeology it is called a tumulus or tumuli. The biggest one is Silbury Hill in southern England. What we have here is a tumulus, artificial hill, which is made from these huge blocks, clay, concrete blocks, clay, sandstone blocks, clay, all the way to the top. Lately, a lot of sensitive people are feeling a very powerful source of energy on the very top. Now, how old are Bosnian pyramids? They are covered by soil. If we can figure out the age of the soil, then we can give the minimum age of the pyramid. The scientific discipline that investigates the origin and age of soil is called pedology. Now, there is an institute for pedology in Bosnia, so Professor Esulović, to establish the institute, he has done the sample testing and concluded that the age of the soil is between 12 and 15,000 years. So if the age of soil is over 12,000 years, it means that the pyramid is older than that. The second important dating we've done on the Moon Pyramid, we noticed that those terraces, they consist of two layer blocks, top and base. Top and base. Institute for Materials from Zenica in Bosnia concluded that the top layer is glued to the base. So if it is glued, obviously the binding material was used. And there is a possibility that organic material can be found in the binding material, which can give us a date when they were mixing the whole thing. So from this particular terrace, we remove the top layer, and in the binder we found this brownish material. It really looked like an organic material. So we packed it, shipped it to the Institute for Physics at the Silesian University of Technology in Poland, Gliwice, and they gave us a date, before Christ, 10,350 years, plus minus 50 years, or 12,350 years before present. And this very summer, in June, our volunteers, our first shift, our International Summer Camp for Volunteers, were extended one of the trenches for about 4 feet to the right. And under the layers of soil and on the very top of the concrete blocks, we found this fossilized organic material. It's a leaf. So if you have organic material under the soil, on the top of the concrete blocks, it can give you another minimum age of the structure. We analyze it at the radiocarbon lab in Kiev, Ukraine, and we get this date. 24,800 years plus minus 200 years. So we are going back 25,000 years. Is it the age of the pyramid? Well, we don't know yet. It seems that according to this hard scientific data, it is over 25,000 years. In order to get the final conclusion, of course, we would need to get another 5, 10 radiocarbon datings. But it takes us very long, very deep in the time. How is it possible that the Bosnian pyramids are older than Egyptian ones? You know, in Bosnia we tend to build everything without a permit. So while we were building ours, Egyptians were waiting for the construction permits. Everything we touch in the case of Bosnian pyramid project forever changes our view of the ancient history. These are the first pyramids in Europe. So far we thought that they were never built in Europe. Secondly, they are the largest, the biggest on the planet. Number three, the side orientation is the most precise on the planet. Number four, the concrete blocks, the construction material, is of the best quality on the planet. And now, the oldest pyramids on the planet. What was happening before the end of the last ice age, 12,000 plus years ago? According to the historians and archaeologists, nothing. The era of the caveman. But they are wrong. It seems that they don't read about the sensational archaeological discovery in the last 15 years. On the bottom of the Pacific floor, between the islands of Yonaguni in Japan, Taiwan, and the mainland China, 13 underwater cities have been discovered at the depths of 100 to 250 feet. Obvious megalithic structures. Half-radius terraces. According to the mainstream Japanese scientists, this is a natural formation. They were joined by American and German scientists and by Robert Schock. What is their problem? Well, if, and they obviously are, work of the intelligent hands, people would ask questions. When they were built, who was able to move megalithic stones long time ago? Well, the last time when the Pacific Ocean rose for 250 feet was 12,500 years ago, at the end of the last ice age. And the huge quantities of ice melted and the water level of world seas and oceans